Very good afternoon, dear Toastmasters.
Good afternoon.
First of all, I'd like to say that I am really happy and pleased to be here sharing the stage with you all once again after a really long time. And it is reminding a lot of memories for me. Please don't start yet. Thank you. Okay, so that being said, thank you, Toastmaster Suman, for that beautiful introduction. And I would like to add one thing about myself, that one of my hobbies is cooking. Especially after marriage, you know what happens. After breakfast is done, okay, what's next? What's for lunch? After lunch is done, okay, what's for dinner today? Again for tomorrow morning, what's for the breakfast? So all in all, it's like a hobby now to cook, and I really enjoy it. But a lot of times what happens is, my audience is as gentle as a lamb in giving me good feedback. But before serving the food, I always give them a disclaimer that please don't go by the looks of the food. It'll taste good. And as I said, they are kind enough to agree with me. But sometimes when I prepare poha or avlaki bhat, as you all must know it, it becomes like a lump. And it's really not pleasing to the eyes. Although it might taste good. So I have understood that presentation really matters. As we speak here in Toastmasters, how much do we care about the presentation of our speech? Now, I am not here to tell more about the body language, the gestures, or the vocal variety, but the speech in itself. How well are we presenting it in terms of what are the strategies and what are the special things that we are using in the speech. A lot of times we have a simple narration of our life events, which is very well taken by the audience because the audience is always kind. But is it enough, or can we spice things up a little bit? How about some mouth-watering metaphors, some salty similes sprinkled here and there, addition of some alliterations? But wait a minute. What are these things which I'm talking about really? How many of us know the difference between a simile and a metaphor? Okay, so is it good to use them? Definitely it is. So what is a simile? A simile is something like which compares one thing to another. So we clearly say in a simile that as hot as coal, or as cool as a winter morning. And these things are fairly easy to add in our speech. So that's simile. What is a metaphor? It's again a comparison of something to something, but it's more implicit rather than straight away there, right? So a beauty, some, I have some examples. I know I'll be shooting the time. But okay, so a nice one which I read somewhere. The heart is a lump of coal that becomes a diamond because of the pain it goes through. I think that's a beautiful metaphor. Coming to the next one, alliterations. What are alliterations? Alliterations are really easy to use. Like I just said, salty similes sprinkled here and there. That is an alliteration. Alliteration is a combination of adjacent words which have a similar beginning of letter or sound. Okay, so that's alliteration. So we are—we all like to use these, but these things don't come to us naturally. What happens is we are not very, English is not our native language, that's for sure. And hence these things don't come naturally. But there are ways to get these things in our speech. How can we do that? Most of us write our speech in MS Word, correct? If you write in Notepad, please switch to MS Word. Because MS Word has an inbuilt thesaurus, and you can right click on some of these words, and then you can find synonyms, you can find antonyms, you can find the meanings of all of those words. So it's easy, fairly easy to incorporate them in your speech. And then we have the Master Google, and you get a lot of similes and metaphors there. All you need to do is find out that part of your speech which can be enhanced and beautified and made better. So you have to find the place where there are expressions, where there are some emotions which can be enhanced by the use of these metaphors and similes. Now before you take my advice, what I would like to do is give you some a word of caution that first thing is that we do not have to overdo these things. For that, make sure that the speech sounds right to yourself, first thing, and then review it with your mentor or with one or two peers, because they will tell you whether the meaning is being conveyed or is it just words, words, words. So we do not have to overdo. Secondly, if the words are new for you, you must practice them so that it looks natural and not by-hearted. Third, the main OBC and the three key takeaways of a speech are the soul and spirit, and they cannot be replaced by these words, alliterations, etc. So overall, as I work towards presenting my food better, I know you all are great speakers and great writers. Use these tips to enhance your speech and embellish them more. Back to you.